This video is for multi-digit multiplication, two-digit by two-digit. So maybe you have a strength in two-digit by one-digit, but once you add that second digit in, you get a little confused. So this is a great review of this major concept. Again, we're going to be using area model because that's what our overall strength is and preferences is using area model. But remember, you can use any strategy that works for you. Just a little joke. Why did the boy do multiplication problems on the floor? His teacher told him not to use his tables. Of course, you're allowed to use your multiplication table if you don't know your facts, but you're trying not to rely so much on that. Those need to start becoming rote in memory. Your objective? I can solve a 2 or 3 digit by a 2 digit multiplication problem. Today, we're just going to be focusing on 2 by 2, but if you want to add that third, go for it. Remember, before we start, have a growth mindset. Remember the learning pit? You'll always have aspects where you're confused. It's not as easy as you thought, but just work your way through that pit, keep working at it, and you'll be successful. You'll understand it. The big idea, you need to know how to multiply for many reasons. There's many times in life that you need to know how to multiply, especially 2-digit by 2-digit or greater. Banking, cooking and baking, building, party planning, traveling, and there's multiple careers where you need to know how to multiply. A review of key vocabulary. A factor are numbers we can multiply together to get a product, and a product is the answer to a multiplication problem. So again, 3 times 2, the factors are 3 and 2. The answer 6 is the product. This is what an area model looks like. It's a model for math problems where the length and width are compiled using either multiplication or other things. Remember, our focus today is just on multiplication. Quick review, multiplying by powers of 10. 3 times 1 is 3, 3 times 10 is 30, 3 times 100 is 300. So hopefully you see that pattern. 1010, 2020s, and then 3 times 1,000, there's 3 zeros, so you add 3 zeros. A common mistake is multiplying each digit as if it represents the place value of 1s. Just reminding yourself of that mistake so you don't make it in the future. All right, we are ready for model number 1. 45 times 60. I'm first going to take 45, break it up using expanded, 40 and 5. Then I'm going to take 62 on the side and split it up into 60 and 2. Now I'm ready to multiply. First I have 60 times 40. I know 6 times 4 is 24. And I have 2 zeros. I'm going to add them there. Then I have 60 times 5. I know 6 times 5 is 30. But it's by 60, so I need to add that extra 0. That is usually a common mistake students make. They'll say, oh, 60 times 5 is 30, and they'll just have that 0. Oh, 1010. Remember that mistake when you're working through these problems. 40 times 2, 4 times 2 is 8, and I have that 0, 80. And 5 times 2 is 10. And now that I have all those filled in, I'm going to take those numbers and add them all together. So I have 24, 100, 300, 80, plus 10. 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 0 is 0. 0, 0, 8, and 1 is 9. 4 plus 3 is 7. And 2 plus nothing is 2. So I know my product is 2,709. Review of the steps that I did. I first drew an area model, then I break up each number using expanded notation. I multiply each place value place individually, then I add for the final product. So let's work on model number 2 using those steps as our guide. I have 53 times 42. I'm first going to draw my area model, starting drawing for me. Then I'm going to break up each number using expanded notation. I'm going to take 53, split it into 50 plus 3 on top. I'm going to take 42, 40 plus 2. Now I'm going to multiply each place individually. 5 times 4 is 20, and I have 2 zeros. 4 times 3 is 12, and I have 1 zero, 120. 2 times 5 is 10, plus 0, 100. So 50 times 2 is 100. And 38 times 2 is 6. So I've done step 3. I've multiplied each place individually. Now I'm ready for my last step, adding all of those for my final product. So I have 2,000 plus 120 plus 100 plus 6. And please note, while I'm adding, I'm keeping my place values lined up. So when I'm adding, I don't make the mistake of shifting them around, which is what some kiddos like to do. 0 plus 0 plus 0 plus 6 is 6. 0 plus 2 plus 0 is 2. 0 plus 1 plus 1 is 2. And 2 plus nothing, 2. So my final product for 53 times 42 is 2,226. Now you try at home. Please click pause while you wait while you solve this problem. I have the steps here for you. It's 28 times 14. So go ahead, click pause, try it on your own. All right, here comes the answer. So if you're still not ready, click pause now. Here it comes. 28 times 14, you should have gotten a product of 392. You should have broken it up using expanded notation, 20 and 8, 10 and 4, gotten 200 plus 80 plus 80 plus 32, with a total of 392. If you got it, great job. If not, look back. Where did you make the mistake? Was it when you were multiplying? Did you forget to add a zero? Or was it an adding mistake? Look back, reflect, see if you can get it right this time now that you know your mistake. If you're ready to practice at home before we do this in class with each other, here's a great website for games that give you two-digit by two-digit, or if you want to challenge yourself, you can even go to the next level of three-digit by two-digit. Thank you.